and welcome to Fate's Take, where I talk about anything and everything that I find interesting. Today I'm taking a request from loyal viewer Jillian Quigley, and I'll be ranking every short from the ACI At Your Fingertips series. The At Your Fingertips shorts are used to teach kids how to make different arts and crafts projects. The problem is, they're the most insanely bizarre projects you could never think of. Each short takes a random medium for the children to use in every monstrosity they'll be learning to make, and they go from there. These are some of the best shorts Rift Trek has ever done, just thanks to how weird they all are, and I'm here to decide which one of these oddities towers above the rest. Now, there was only one problem with covering these shorts. Most of them have both live and studio versions. Which version should I compare? Well, at first I thought, it's not fair to the shorts that only have studio versions to compare them to live show ones, so I'll just do all the studio ones. The problem is that the short featuring Sugar and Spice is only available in live form, even when sold individually. We're gonna roll with it, and I'm gonna do my best to not let the fact that it's live affect my decision. With all that said, let's dive in with every Rift Trek At Your Fingertips short ranked.
Homemade clay is a happening scene, a psychedelic, groovy soft machine.
Homemade clay is far out.
Here we have the first and only crafting material that makes some semblance of sense. We see children learning how to make homemade clay for when their parents are too cheap to spend money on Play-Doh. After seeing these children try and fail at following the narrator's simple directions, we're treated to all of their weird creations.
1 cup of salt.
Roughly the same amount you'll find in a can of Campbell's soup.
2 cups of flour.
Whoa. Bit generous on your measurements there, kid.
1 cup of water.
Yeah, more or less.
These poor children have a measuring disability.
No,
it's my turn.
Come on, you guys. I never get to do anything.
I'm going to jump out. You're not my boss. Shut up.
Plastic wrap keeps the clay from sticking to the table and makes it easy to pick up.
But let's face it, you're just going to let it harden like a rock till your parents throw it out.
You can shape an animal by laying it over a roll of paper to dry.
I assume he means a clay animal, not a real animal.
Just scratch out his eyes here because he disobeyed me.
And here's how it looks once an adult took over.
Bootleg Madeline figurines are $1 billion industry in China.
Make things from clay, such as seals.
Interestingly, even though you'd think we'd actually get some compelling craft ideas here, we get less ideas in this short than any of the others in the series. So when we're crafting with grass, we get like a dozen ideas, but with easily moldable clay where the only limit is your imagination, we get like 2 different suggestions.
Brilliant colors make pretty jewelry.
Sorry, I meant to say pretty earplugs.
Yeah.
Jewelry. Soft, shapeless, and dull, the way everyone likes it. Form a clay California and cackle with glee as its infrastructure crumbles.
I'm playing with clay, but what do I call it?
Play, clay, play.
Add a tail to your creation. Oh, did I say creation? I meant abomination.
Formal soundtrack reminding us that inbred 18th century aristocrats love to play with clay.
Yeah.
Turn the sculpture over and remove the plastic wrap so the underside of the clay may dry thoroughly.
Yes, it truly is a sculpture worthy of Rodin.
Through the holes you make with a pencil, you can thread soft yarn to make a necklace.
You can, but you probably shouldn't. We're not recommending it, mind you, just saying it's a quantum possibility of a thing that a person could do.
Got it.
Though probably shouldn't.
Got it.
You'll be the bell of the volcano god sacrifice ceremony.
Yes, child, put me on.
The reason this one takes the lowest spot is because while the riffs are hilarious, the crafts just aren't crazy enough for my taste.
Once you've finished, really reflect on how you've spent the last hour. It'll be a clarifying moment in your life.
Cardboard cylinders come in many sizes, and there are many things that you can make from them.
Bobby's making his grandpa a fully functional artificial heart.
This short has the oddest subject matter of them all. The usual specific type of garbage we're supposed to play with is replaced with a specific shape instead. Yes, cylinders, the most creative of shapes, even though half the time there isn't even a cylinder in the shot.
Round tubes like these are called cylinders.
If that comes as news to you, it means you probably lack a brainstem.
Okay, boys and girls, put down your algebra books. We're gonna watch a kid cut a paper star in real time.
at your fingertips cylinders, right?
Cylinders, yes, that's right.
Cylinders, known for their rectangular shape and two-dimensionalness.
Hey, kids, make sure a cylinder's in the shot, or else we lose our state funding, huh?
Yep, when I think cylinders, I think harpsichord music.
We actually discussed the short a couple months ago during the Riff Tracks Live Manos the Hands of Fate review.
When you experiment with cylinders, you will discover many ways of combining them.
You can combine two cylinders to make one long, cylinder!
And while very good, live or not, I still felt I couldn't rank this any higher. One thing that I realized while watching these all together is that this one has less dark and dismal riffs than most of the others. And while this may sound horrible, I find that the scarier the riffs, the funnier the at-your-fingertip short is.
This effigy of your math teacher will look so good you won't even want to burn it on his lawn.
Oatboxes and oatmeal boxes joined together make a big totem pole.
Put it outside your cardboard casino. Cut more! Blue everything! More glitter! Kill a hobo!
What's that, Mr. Narrator?
Oatmeal containers!
Let the others mock us, Petey. You and I are one. You and I are one.
After he'd hung his 300th oatmeal box ungulate, Petey's parents began to worry.
Top automotive engineers hard at work on a new Saturn. I brought one of these cars to the Pinewood Derby. Yep, first kid ever to be dishonorably discharged from Cub Scouts.
Really fun short, just not twisted enough for me.
What new things can you find to make with cylinders?
Cylinders make all sorts of insane abominations against God possible.
Yep, a close-up of a child eating a kitchen sponge. This fits right in with the series.
Here we have the only short on the list available exclusively in a live show form from the Santa Claus Show. And while watching it, I found it to be perfectly smack dab in the middle of the series for me. We see kids making completely unexplained sugar sculptures, and they get way more creative here than in the Play Clay short where all these sculptures would have made way more sense.
When the sugar has dried, it becomes very hard.
So, scoop some congealed Pepto-Bismol into a cone, I don't know. Yeah.
But when you dampen it with a little water, you can shape it with your fingers.
But why do that when you could cut up your little brother's football with scissors instead?
This colored mixture of sugar and water can be used as glue.
Don't you already know how to make pink glue out of sugar and water? Well, there's no film to teach you that, kid. Just go outside and stare at the sun or something.
Icing can also be used for decoration.
Get creative decorating this thing, even though we've given you no indication what it's going to be or why you're making it.
Almost any smooth, hollow shape will mold the sugar.
Yes, Timmy, the skull of a dead mouse would do it too, but your questions are a little morbid, son.
Sorry.
A clove makes a good bird's beak.
And what makes a good bird, you ask? The widely accepted standard is one that doesn't peck your eyes out.
Light comes through the sugar crystals and lights the inside of the egg.
But remember, it is also staring back at you.
Next, we see all the ugly ornaments the children have created. Just how many drugs do you think the creators of this installment were on at the time, anyway?
You love racquetball more than me, huh, Dad? We'll see about that!
You can use round balls to make many different things.
Do not attempt with square balls.
And then Mr. Snowman got his throat slit.
And because Frosty is a serial adulterer, this big scarlet A.
Then have Burl Ives breathe his dark gift of life into your creature.
Appreciate the effort, kid, but my nose is actually blocking one eye. It's pretty sick. You're sick, kid.
If your mold is paper or cardboard, line it with plastic so the sugar won't stick.
Line your garbage with other garbage to create future garbage. It's the circle of trash.
Well, now that I got a closer look, it all makes sense.
Yeah.
There's a note in there that reads, "While you wasted hours of your life, I bought a dozen kick-ass ornaments for like $2.
A meal fit for a clown.
Make a crab bowl and put a boat in it. What, you got something better to do?
It's fun to make things of sugar, and they are good to eat.
What? Just grab a slice of instant diabetes, kids.
This one definitely gets wacky and bizarre, but unbelievably, things only get funnier from here. And I think it really speaks to the quality of the next two that they actually beat out a live performance.
Once your blue meth is 98% pure, you're ready to take out Heisenberg.
Spend the irreplaceable hours of your youth slowly plodding along encased in garbage.
We open this joyous romp with a kid in a makeshift jail cell. That's always a good sign, right? Actually, if that doesn't perfectly sum up this series, I don't know what does. We've all played with boxes when we were little. Usually we'd just sit in them and pretend they were a race car or something, but these kids are a little more ambitious. Instead of just sticking to handheld crafts like the ones we've seen so far, these kids construct tunnels, houses, and even their own moving vans. Poorly made, depressing-looking tunnels, houses, and moving vans.
At your fingertips, prisons. Boxes. Prisons made of boxes.
Yeah, I did it, and I'd do it again. Letter blocks cost too much, honey. Use these.
And E. The B, Shyamalan twist.
These have been put together with pipe cleaners to make a tunnel.
No, don't crawl through. You'll emerge in another dimension of eternal pain.
Save all the boxes that come into your house. You can soon build a city.
Then wreck it and call it Detroit.
Hey, it's the Full House houses. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's a heart, a hand to hold on to.
You can spray milk cartons with paint and add colored paper.
Yeah, well, you can also drop rocks off of bridges onto the genitals of an unconscious drifter. Doesn't mean you should.
Forget playing stickball, Timmy. Slap on another coat of fuchsia.
Oh, yes.
Well, this is what you get when Muppets educate our children.
While the projects themselves may not be quite as insane as the last couple of shorts, this one is some of the darkest and most depressing riffs, which I think gives it a distinct advantage over the others.
This is fun! I'm glad we overthrew our parents!
Okay, good. Now one more unbearably depressing touch, and... perfect!
I wish I could forget.
And now dental hygiene for the criminally insane.
Sweatshops of the past were a lot more wacky and pointless.
Hi there, stick of butter with eyeballs. I'd like to see anyone say you're an imaginary friend now.
Kissy lips? I don't like where this is heading.
Hi, clown face demon. Wanna play?
No, today we harvest souls.
Other side of that milk carton has a photo of the last kid who made his own clown face demon.
Place the bodies face down in the pool for the hardened pipe cleaner homicide detective to discover bloated and gray the next morning.
You gotta learn not to see people. Just bodies. Just see bodies.
Corrugated.
My childhood just ended.
Trust us, kids, it's even more joyless and life-sapping than it looks.
God, someone cut the brakes! We're gonna plow into the house!
I'll tie him up. You go for the jewelry.
You know it.
Simulate moving, like Mommy and Daddy are going to do while you go to summer camp. Jim and Bob will spend the rest of their lives pretending they didn't see all those dead dogs inside the playhouse.
Dark and depressing, yet hilarious and upbeat, this one definitely earns the number two spot.
Jim and Bob pulled a Thelma and Louise that afternoon.
Their parents sued the Cardboard Box Council.
They lost. The court costs bankrupted them, and they moved into a box in their former backyard.
Boxes!
Glue dried grass on painted boxes to make pretty gifts.
Oh, sorry, I missed a word there. Pretty crappy gifts.
Come on, you all saw this coming. Here it is, the original, the classic, At Your Fingertips Grasses. Originally a part of the Reefer Madness live show, this short is absolute madness, even by ACI standards. It's also one of the best riff track shorts out there, and is a great one to show someone you're trying to introduce to the riffing world. While with the past four shorts the crafts have been dumb, like really dumb, you can at least see where most of the ideas are coming from. However, never in my entire life would I ever have even imagined a child conceiving of the idea of making earrings, crayon rubbings, and fancy headdresses out of the filthy weeds from their backyard.
How can you tell grass from other plants?
If it's uninteresting and not worth devoting a film to, it's probably grass.
but we usually cut it down before it has finished growing.
Just like this overgrown field. Okay, bad example.
Then is corn grass?
You know, I lie in bed at night wondering just that. Finally, I'll have an answer. Finally, an answer.
Huh? Lay a piece of paper over it and rub it with a crayon.
Nothing says, I forgot it was Father's Day, like a grass rubbing.
Yes, after a few grass rubbings, your students will be begging you to give them a thrilling math quiz.
Damn it, is corn grass or not?
Hair bands, belts.
Hair bands.
There. And now you can use this to comb your bookmark. Yeah, your bookmark.
Be sure to apologize to the library for all the grass stains and dead aphids.
Perhaps you would like to mix a few leaves with the grass.
Perhaps you'd also like to add some corn, which might be grass. Have you no way of knowing, apparently.
Now pay attention, because in hour two, we'll show you...
Oh, no!
The jokes here are simply hilarious. This short just gives the guys a ridiculous amount of material to work with, and they come out with some of the most gut-bustingly funny riffs we've ever been given. And like I mentioned earlier, the darker the lines, the better the at your fingertips short.
It's the gift that tells her, pay attention to me because I'm unstable and might be outside your window right now.
Oh, my
goodness. Dried grass keeps very well. Sometimes it can be added to clay sculptures.
Satan welcomes these offerings and will smite your enemies with grass.
Cool sculpture, Timmy.
Thanks. It told me we should kill our parents.
Radical.
What am I?
While the grass is still green, you can braid the stems, as you would braid hair.
But unlike that uptight girl on the subway, grass won't mace you when you try to braid it.
Tie them with yarn, and you can wear them.
Until your cheapskate boyfriend gets the hint.
God, I hope my friends never see this.
Twist a wire around the end of a braid, and you have a snake's head.
Oh, you didn't want a snake's head? Well, maybe if you didn't flunk spelling again, we'd buy you a real toy.
Oh, my God!
Just a few drops of your sweet, innocent child blood, your creations come alive. Oh, what fresh hell is this?
Psst. Hey, kid. Could you help me out here? Is corn grass? Because it's killing me. It's really gnawing us.
A fun craft activity and a desperate plea for help.
With grass, it is easy to make fancy headdresses.
Because how many times does your kid ask you, Mom, can I please have a fancy headdress?
And it's a neat strategy if you ever need to get out of jury duty.
Colored masks are fun.
This expression of Ronnie's madness, however, is not fun. It's sad and a little scary.
No other way around it, this one definitely earns the top spot. And I suggest going out and buying it right now if you haven't already.
You will worship me. I am the great god of Apukti, and I demand sacrifice.
grass.
And that was every Riff Tracks At Your Fingertips short ranked. I want to thank Jillian Quigley again for this awesome idea. I had a really fun time making this video. And I want to thank you all for watching it as always. I think my next video I'll finally be getting around to reviewing the Crawling Eye episode of Mystery Science Theater 3000. And I hope to see you guys there. Thanks again, and I'll see you guys later. You can't dry out, so you can't stand still, do the ball more.